Bum, 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 bum. How do I share? Present, present. Window, and we'll share this one. Okay. Is it readable? Yeah, I guess so. Okay. Wanted to make some noble characters, preferably a family. I've tried this before. I'm just thinking out loud here because I want to make some changes to this program. I follow the rules from Mongoose Traveler 2nd edition, or was it 1st edition? No, these are Mongoose Traveler 1st edition, right? Yeah, it just says Mongoose Traveler 1st edition. Is that even there? Is that even showing up? No, it doesn't show up. So in 1st edition, you create your home world, then you create your character based on your home world. So we'll do that. Make a home world. So what do we got? Standard atmosphere. Non-industrial, tens of thousands, middle class. Okay. That looks like a good enough planet. So I'll lock it so that it keeps using that same planet. So now what I do, I'm going to ignore this character here, unless they're a noble. They don't look like they're a noble. So I'm going to choose noble. There we go. And make them old. And let's have a female, I guess. Anything else? Should she be psionic? Let's make her psionic. Give her a strength of what? 9 or something. See what happens. Did it make it? It's thinking. Okay, so we got somebody. 82 years old. Marchioness Tierley. Something, something of something. So we're still using the same homeworld we made. And we'll just keep using that same homeworld. So all these nobles will be coming from Stenor. Let's see. There's no law level? That's weird. So she started out as a wild talent survivor, became a drifter, and now she was a diplomat ambassador for 10 terms. What? What? Socia 14. Let's see. What's her? She's got deception 5, carouse 5, persuade 2, diplomat 2. Man. Okay. Blade, blade, blade. So got a bunch of free blades. Let's see. Got a pension. 250,000 credits. And a business thing of $1 million. And a property thing of $10 million. Anyway, a yacht. A yacht and a yacht and a yacht. So too many yachts. This person's been places, got things done. Okay, so she'll be like the boss of the family. So now what I do is I copy the last name. The last name. I'm trying to remember how did I do nobles? How did I do their names? Was this last name the father's last name, or oh, I don't remember now. I'll just go with They have three names. If they're this high up in rank, they'll have three names. So the last one's their last name. So I'm going to copy that one here. And she has a son. Let's make him younger. He's probably going to be 50-something, 50-ish, maybe 49-ish. Now I'll make him 50. 55, let's see how that works. Hopefully, these are approximate ages, no guarantees. He might end up being older than the mom. And he is not psionic. And I want him to be some kind of a soch thing. Maybe a soch of 10, at least. Anything else? And he's nobility also. Okay, fire away. See if this works. So we're using the same planet. So her kid's name is Opalus. He's 60 years old. And what's his claimed fame? He was a scout, a courier scout for 2 terms. What is that, 8 years? Then he was a drifter. What's with the drifters? Barbarian. He's in the barbarian career as a barbarian. His rank was barbarian, and he was there for... First time was incomplete. Then he was in there for eight years. And then he became an administrator supervisor for 12 years. So what has he got? He's got advocate. He's got spacecraft. Deception and diplomat. He's got some survival skills. He knows Anglic and Volani, he's got recon, navigation. Yeah, he's your typical thing. Spacecraft is what? That's the he can go planet to planet pretty well. He doesn't do the jump drive all that much. He's got astrogation though. Let's see. He's got TSA, TSA, TSA. Okay. He's got some cash, no debt, no pension either. How come no pension? I'll have to look and see what he was up to. Let's see. He spent several years jumping from world to world in a scout ship. Okay, so small craft is the one that just goes from planet to planet, and spacecraft is the one that goes from star to star. Okay, so he does do the star jumping. I'm not used to these Mongoose first edition skills. I'll have to get used to it though, because that's what I wrote this for 10, 12 years ago. Let's see. So he gained navigation 1 for doing the scout thing. He was a trainee. Then he became a scout. He discovered a world of worth to the Imperium. He automatically got promoted. At 28, there was a mishap and he got injured. He became a drifter as a barbarian. At age 32, there was a mishap. Someone he never saw coming. He has a new enemy. So he's got 3 enemies. What? 3 enemies? Oh, I forgot to look at the enemies for the mom. Let's see. What are we going to do here? This is where I need to copy paste stuff. I should have copied and pasted. Oh, well. I'll have to do that. I'll do that later. This thing stores a whole database of characters. I can go look for them the hard way. So he got a new enemy. So someone he never saw coming betrayed him, ending his career. So he became another drifter as a barbarian at age 36. And a lucky break finds him good fortune that he's dreamed of. And he gains 2 benefit points. Blah, blah, blah. That would be probably the 2 ship shares, maybe. Then he got, at 40, he got attacked by enemies. He escaped uninjured. That's good. At 60, look at it. At 60, he's not injured. At 60, he's still a good character. He's not, like, bedridden or anything. Let's see. At 44, there was a mishap. Oh, man. It's always a mishap with this guy. He runs afoul of a corrupt bureaucrat. Gain an enemy. Which he does. And he's a member of... Now he's at 48, he's a member of nobility as an administrator. His reign is acclaimed by all and is as being fair and wise. He gains an unhappy subject as an enemy. Gains a +2 in advancement. Okay. At 52, he's a clerk. Disaster. War strikes. Deception worked for his escape. He gets promoted. At age 56, he's a supervisor. Becomes deeply involved in politics on his world of residence. Becoming a player in the political intrigues of government. Gains 1 level in admin and also gain a rival. He left the nobility career after 3 terms. And he got ship share and 3 TSAs. Okay. The AI used was 6 for that. The AI... What's... 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So he was just using random tables. The AI was just using random tables to get skills and attributes and stuff from. That's weird. So this guy is kind of like... When you're using random tables like that, that means you're just going to be more, what do they call it, less focused and more well-rounded character. Okay, and this guy has a brother. So this guy's age is 60. His brother is going to be around the same age. It's thinking. I'm using brute force, so it made 209 characters before it found the right one. So it found the right one. And Sir Wager V. Anyway, so he's 4 years younger than his brother. He's disabled. He has no endurance. Let's read. What happened to him? What happened to you? So his background skills are drive, engineer, and admin. He joined the Space Marines. Or the Star Marines, as they're called, I guess. At age 20, he was a Marine at rank 0. He was on the front lines of a planetary assault. And occupation, he gained recon. So what is he having? He's got advocate, deception, battle dress. Wow. He's got slug rifle, slug pistol. 0G. He was doing army training. He was only in the Space Marines for 16 years. Is that what happened? So at age 24, he becomes a Lance Corporal. An ex-lover tracked him down. That's not good. So he's got family members. He's involved with one right now. Ex-lover, huh? So he attempts the commission role and succeeds. He's now a lieutenant at age 28. He's trapped behind enemy lines, and he has to survive on his own. He gains Deception 1. He gets promoted at age 32. He's now a captain. A mission goes disastrously wrong due to his commander's error, but he survives. He says nothing to protect him, gaining the commander as an ally. So he's got one ally who's a terrible commander, I guess. He left the Marines after 4 terms, got some edu, got some int, got some monies, got some armor. At 36, he becomes a diplomat. He's an intern at rank 0. An ex-lover tracks him down again. What? That can't be. And this time he becomes involved in a new romantic relationship. Man, this guy's always... He's something. He's 40 years old. He's an intern. He's got women chasing him down. Let's see. What does it say here? His efforts do not go unnoticed by the Imperium. So he's automatically promoted. So at 48, he's now third secretary. Uh-oh, your lover may be cheating on you. That's not good. That sounds like a fortune cookie. Your lover may be cheating on you. Okay, so he's got family members. One of them's cheating on him. That's good. He's 52 now. He's disaster. War strikes. Deception worked for his escape. He leaves the nobility career after 25 years. No, after 20 years. And there's an aging crisis. Oh no, he has to pay. No, he gets debt. He gets debt added to his thing. So I guess he had some money to spend. So he's not in complete debt. Yeah, he had some money before he got injured, so he still has some debt after getting himself fixed. Because he's taking some drugs so he wouldn't die of accelerated decrepitude. So his endurance is brought to 1. It was 0, I guess. And he's got stocks, business, yacht. Oh, he has a yacht. Oh, he has 2 yachts. He has 2 yachts. And he got some social. Okay, now let's make a sister for these people. Probably that age, around that age, we'll see. Lady Abripila, something. Anyway, she's 55. So she's, what, a year younger than the brother? And she's disabled. What's her sad tale? She started out as a drifter. She was a scavenger at the age of 15. What happened to her? It says she doesn't know what happened to her. Okay, I'm trying to figure out what happened to her, and the computer's telling me she doesn't know what happened to her. There's a gap in her memory. And then she gets drafted into the scout service, doing exploration at age 19 as a trainee. And she survived on an alien world, gaining training 1. Training 1? What is training? Come on, what is training? Is that even the right word? I've customized Traveler so much. I can't remember what the stock skills are anymore in Traveler. So I'm going to open up my PDF, Mongoose Traveler, first edition. Bum ba da bum. Anytime now. Oh, I've got like 500 PDFs all open at once, so it takes a while to open this program. Not going anywhere. Come on, computer. Yep, I went to get some pizza, and the pizza place was the only thing open. It was weird. I was playing Last Man Alive today. I forgot that it was, I guess, Memorial Day or something. So tomorrow I'll probably go to the fort and look at all the tombstones from World War II and World War I. I'm not gonna go there. I'm not gonna go there on Memorial Day. That'd be crazy. It's like going to Disneyland on a Saturday. Okay, where am I at? Which one is it? I have too many of these open. Nope, that's Traveler 5. Traveler 5, Python stuff. GURPS, 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 GURPS. Mongoose Traveler, Traveler Explorers Edition. I bought that for a buck. I'd buy that for a dollar. Rifts? Second edition Core Traveler. Come on. Another Traveler 5 book. Something about Gygax. Gygax GM Emulator. I need to run that. I need to run that program and try it out. It's Gary Gygax GMing a game, but it's like, it's an AI. I'm sure it's gonna suck. Come on, Mongoose Traveler, where are you? There it is, there it is. Lock on to it. Okay. Skills. Now, what is training? Was there a training in first edition Mongoose? I'm not seeing it. What is training? There's trade. There's 0G. There's vac suit. There's tactics. I don't see a training. I thought I converted this all back to Mongoose Traveler First Edition. Maybe there's some shenanigans going on with it still. Training 1? Oh, it might be a specialty skill. So that would be what? What? Animal training? Let's go look at animals here. Oh, it's training for animals. That's what it is. So the character knows how to tame and train animals. Taming a strange creature. I've never tried to tame a strange creature yet in Traveler. The thing either kills me or we kill it. Okay, that makes sense. So let's go back to here. So this is what, the little sister that we're doing? Okay, she survived on an alien world when she was 19. And gained training 1. So that means she was talking to the animals. Like Dr. Zhivago or something. Now, at 23, there was a mishap. Her ship is damaged, and she has to hitchhike her way back across the stars to the nearest star base. She gained 3 contacts and 3 enemies. Wow. And she got a weapon. Okay. And she becomes a drifter as a scavenger. And at age 27, there's a mishap. She ran afoul of a corrupt bureaucrat gained an enemy. Then she became a drifter as a wanderer at age 31. And there was a mishap. She got injured. She became a drifter as a barbarian. At 35, there was a mishap. She ran afoul of a criminal gang, gained an enemy. Man, she's having a rough life. First, she starts out with missing memories. And now she's a member. At age 39, she becomes a member of nobility as a dilettante. How is dilettante wastrel for the next 16 years? Wow. So she's challenged to a duel for her honor and standing. She refuses to accept and loses some of her soche. Ow. At 43, she makes an alliance with a powerful and charismatic noble who becomes an ally. She gains +4 advancement DM to her whatever role thanks to his aid. She gets promoted. At age 47, she's a rank 1 wastrel. Someone close to her dies. She goes through an aging crisis. And she has no money. She has no money. So she owes the hospital some bills. Her strength is brought back and her dexterity is brought back. At age 51, she becomes deeply involved in politics on her world of residence, becoming a player in the political intrigues of government. She gains 1 level in persuade and also gains a rival. Man, she's got 1 rival, 5 enemies. She's doing okay. She is a social butterfly in the far future, in the year, 5628. And again, she goes through another aging crisis. Her strength is brought back to 1. Her dexterity is brought back to 1. She gets a yacht, and some estate portfolio, and TAIS, and 2 ship shares, some more money. Oh, she's got more money. She has enough money to pay off her debt if she wants. Okay. Now, one of the brothers is going to have a kid. So that kid is going to be... ...24-ish. Yeah, maybe 15-ish. And what else we want to do here? He might be a bastard kid, so no social standing. Maybe his social standing will just be whatever he makes of it, I guess. And a dude. And what else? I don't want to have, incest going on, so I'm making sure I got everything set up right here. Fire away. What does it sound like if it talks? It's thinking.
This rather young 20-year-old male administrator was born in 1085 to a middle-upper-class family on a non-industrial world whose culture is unusual custom. Off-worlders, he goes by the name of Ilison Ikumer.
Okay, so that one used the AI of 3, which is advanced education. Okay. So this person's 16 years old. So, no. Was it? Okay, they got physical sciences, language, and carouse, and at the age of 16, they're a member of nobility as administrator. There's a mishap, an assassination attempts to end, an assassin attempts to end his life. He's nearly killed. That's interesting. It doesn't put anything in there. So, oh, he had an incomplete term. That's probably why he doesn't have a rival or anything. I think you only get rivals and contacts and enemies and stuff if you complete a 4-year term. Anyway, so now he's 20. And what skills does he have? He's got Persuade. And he's got Carouse. He has nothing. Who else to make? Okay, so the lover of one of the brothers. I'm going to do a female here. This will be the mom of that kid we just made. So we have no idea what she's going to even be like. Maybe make her a Nexus 6. Why not? And make her 48-ish. Okay, fire away, right? Got everything set right? Use AD for year. What else? I want her to be psionic for some reason. I don't know why. Fire away. It's made 300 characters already. It takes longer to make a planet and a character that matches all the settings I got here.
This elderly 55-year-old psionic female dilettante was born in 5569 AD to an extraordinary class family on a non-industrial agricultural world whose culture is unusual customs, sex. She goes by the name of Baroness Hida Mokenchi Asujinor.
Okay, so she's the mom of the kid I made before this one. And what's her story? She's a baroness. She comes from a different planet. An extraordinary social class. Low law level. Feudal technocracy. She's Nexus 6, so she's undamaged. She's got some decent stats here. The planet she's from is agricultural, non-industrial, hundreds of thousands of people. She has a long-ass name. Baroness Hida Mokenchi Asujinor of Alcancesnor. Okay, so what is her thing? She started out on a planet with the FBEF. She started out as FBEBDC. Man, all capital letters. It's pretty good. It's pretty good rolls for your UPP. She's got 5 background skills. So it's what? Animals, computers, space sciences, life sciences, and drive. Now the computers, the animals, the space sciences, the life sciences, when those come up, and when drive comes up, whenever a generic skill like that comes up, the computer automatically assigns a specialty. So for animals, it would have picked something like veterinary. So I guess veterinary instead of animals. Computers, does this, okay, let me check. Does first edition doesn't have specialized computers. It's just computer. So when you say you have computer skill, that's it. It's just you just have generic computer skill. I think I've played games where I've made computers a specialty, so you have to choose what kind of computers. Let's see here. Because it could just be admin computers, DMV computers, COBOL, Fortran, that kind of stuff. Or it could be AI self-learning stuff, sentient stuff. Let's see. My screen is way too wide here. So for space sciences, she's got psionicology. For life sciences, well, one of them is xenology and one of them is psionicology. Whichever is which. And then for drive, she has tracked. She can drive a tracked mobile. So she encounters the Psionic Institute, goes in for testing. She has a strength of 8. She chose to be trained. How much is that? $1,000? 1,000 credits? Or 5,000 credits to learn? I guess she had money for that. I don't know. It's been a while since I wrote this program, so I don't know how the money gets transferred when you're doing the testing thing. So she chose to be trained as a wild talent at the age of 19. She becomes a fluke. She makes an unexpected connection outside her normal circles and gains a contact. She's got 5 contacts. What? So she gets promoted to survivor at the age of 23. She gains a mentor as an ally and 4 points towards her next advancement thanks to his aid. Promoted at age 27 to rank 2 of survivor, a working friend betrays her and becomes her rival. At the age of 31, she becomes a witch. How long was she doing this for? 24 years, she was a wild talent. Okay. So rank 3 witch. She gains stealth 1 from reflecting her time spent mastering her mind and body. So she still has stealth 1. At 35, she gains a mentor as an ally, yada yada yada. At 39, she gains a mentor as an ally. At 43, she's ranked 5 as a witch and there's a mishap. She's experimented on by the government. She escapes and gains a contact who helped her escape. Let's see. She gains the organization doing the experiments as an enemy. She gets some money. She's got like, what, 4,000 credits? Some of that had to have been spent on the psionic training, I think. I can't remember how much that cost, though. Let's see. She's got 2 ship shares, 4 ship shares, a contact, a contact, a contact. Oh, she's getting contacts like crazy. Is that right? Can you get contacts as mustering out benefits? I didn't think you could do that. Maybe in the psionic career you can get contacts from mustering out. She got 4 contacts. just from leaving the her wastrel career, I guess. No? Yes? No? No, that was all from her psionics. Okay, so she gets out of the psionic business. In 1097, she joins, at the age of 47, the nobility career as a dilettante, and she's a rank zero wastrel. She sponges off her family's wealth, gains a jealous relative as an enemy. At 51, she is now a rank one wastrel. A conspiracy of nobles attempts to recruit her. She refuses and gains the conspiracy as an enemy. She left the nobility career after 2 terms. What is that, 8 years? Boom, boom, boom. And now... what does she have to show for us? So she's a soci of 13. She was using AI3. So AI3 is advanced education. So she was rolling on the advanced education tables during her care gen. Her quirk is she's a secret whatever that word is, user. She's using drugs to keep herself looking young, I suppose. Now, she has an uncle. Some dude. He's going to be pretty old. And he's psionic. And got some social standing going on. And he's from...
Homeworld locked.
Yeah, he's from the same planet she's from. And he's only a Nexus 5. Okay, should we fire away? Got all the thing. Oh, he's not nobility, though. What was he? What would be a good thing he could be in? I'll just make him a scion. How are we going to do this? I don't want him to be more powerful than her. What skills did she learn anyway? She learned, telepathy, telekinesis. What else? Anything else? Okay. Yeah, I don't want him to be as powerful as her, because he's a Nexus 5. Her psionic strength was 8. Okay, looks good. Fire away. Turn off the voice. Coming up on 200 characters, okay. Coming up on 240 characters. This might take a bit. If I watch it, it just takes longer to happen. Hopefully. Oh, I got social standing 11 in there. Why did I do that? What are the chances? Okay. Still possible. not going anywhere. Okay, 650 characters have been made. By now, you think they're going to show up, I hope. Do I have something in there that's causing an infinite loop? Maybe I can't turn off psionics if I want psiona. I was thinking, oh yeah, if you choose psion, you don't need to put a psionic strength in there. Yeah, that's probably what happened. So I'll kill it. I'm gonna kill it off. We'll just have to start again. Bum, bum, bum. Well, I guess the uncle's not going to be from the same planet then, because that planet's gone. Sharing is caring. Okay, so we just want a dude who's an uncle. What was he, 78 or something? Around 78-ish. Nexus 5. He's a scion. And I think I wanted a soch of at least 10. Right? Oh, and he comes from a Tech 10 world. Okay, fire away. Oh man, I messed up again. Come on. I need to fix that. I'm gonna have to fix that in the program. If you choose the Scion career, you have to then choose the level of psionics. I think. Or at least give it a zero. I gotta check my documentation for this program. Okay, a dude, Nexus 5, 78, Soch of 10, Tech level 10, and in here, he just needs at least a psionic strength of 1, it could be more than 1. No, maybe 0. Maybe 0 is what it's supposed to be. Values 0 and 1 are invalid. Okay. Does it say anything for Scion? This thing is so beta still. After 10 years, it's beta. Make it AD. And is that it? I think that's it. Hit new. Cross your fingers. Can't be too hard. Just make a planet that's tech level 10 at least. And make a person who's at least Soch 10 at least. And is psionic 1 at least. It can be done. Made 400 characters already. What is it doing? You know what? I should like make it do the planet first. So then it doesn't have to randomly generate new planets every time it makes a character. So So somewhere in this program, I can break up, separate the world generator from the character generator. And if a planet's already generated, it just makes characters for that planet. Unless you tell it to make a new planet. Because that saves so much time. Because every time you change the strength or the education or a skill level or something, you're just... It's just going to be that much longer because it's a random number generator, so it's going to try its best to make a character that matches your criteria. And I don't even know what version this is. Sometimes I'll yank out the AI engine, put in another one, thinking, ah, that one works better. I'm always borrowing Python code from one of my traveler apps, throwing it into, you know, you take the engine out of one car and you put a new engine in the car and it'll work, everything will be fine. I mean, it can do it eventually. I just want to sit here doing a live stream and the computer's going to take 5 minutes to make a character. So what I'll do is I'll stop it, or just do it the way I've been doing it recently, and that's just make the world first, and then the characters just work after that. Okay, I'm gonna have so many error reports. Abnormal ending. A bunch of ab-end errors in my logs. Abnormal ending occurred. 4 times that night. What were you doing on the computer? I don't want to hear about it. Okay, so first, let's share this. Presents. Okay, first we make a planet. Let's make it a level 10 planet. That's it, right? How about world size? Do I want to mess with the world size? No. Population? No. Based on atmosphere? Based on size? Why not? Let's be different. Oh, Nexus 5. That's right. Nexus 5. No, we're not doing that. Standard. Fire away. Boom! First time. First character rolled is the correct one. Okay, so now we keep that. We keep that planet, which happens to be 1G planet with insidious atmosphere, vac suit needed, 5% water, tens of millions of people, upper, lower class. Okay, so we just ignore we ignore the character that it made. Now we start filling in with the uncle. The uncle is a Nexus 5, 78. A dude, he's got a soch of 10, he's a scion with strength of at least 1, and it's AD where he's from. Is that all I need to do? Fire away. Please work. Now, it should just be making a character, not the whole planet that goes with it. Maybe Scion 1 is wrong. Maybe I can't be doing a psionic strength of 1. Some noob. My name is Sub. Some noob. Well, while that's thinking, I am going to Get a drink. I'll be back. Okay, I think I know what I'm doing wrong. I'm using one for psionic strength, and that's it. An illegal move. 5-yard penalty. Okay, let's try this again. This is an EXE, so I can't just open it and look at the source. Let's see. But it said right here, right? Oh, values 0 and 1 are invalid. Here I'm typing a 1. Okay, we're going to do a 2. We're going to choose Scion. Nexus 5. Dude 78. Based on size, AD, tech level 10, Soch of 10. And of course, I have to start over with a new planet, so change these back to random. Let's just get a character first. See, now I really want to fix this thing so that it's just doing a world and then a character. Instead of doing the world and the character, see, it made 20 characters before it found one that matched this guy. That's counting the world stuff too. So we're going to lock this world, so it doesn't have to keep rolling the planet over and over and over again. So this planet is remarkable. It's got hundreds of people, and the social class is remarkable. Low population, desert world, non-industrial, poor. I forget what poor means. It doesn't mean poor people. It just means the planet doesn't have like stuff worth selling. Like the dirt is just dirt. There's no iron in the dirt, you know what I mean? They don't have plants to sell, they don't have animals to sell, they don't have food to sell, they don't have tech to sell. I think that's what poor means. Right? Okay, so Nexus 5, blah blah blah. So his, let's make that a 2. He's a Scion based on size. Soch of 10. Fire away. Did I remember to lock the world? I think I did. Okay, after 175 characters, we ended up with this one. So we have a baronet. Shisen something 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 of Cory. Or Chori, however you want to say it. So he was born in 5594. He possesses unusually advanced technology. How? How'd you get that? So he's a Nexus 5? Hang on. I said 78. How did he get to be 30? That's wild. Okay, there's a roll you can make. There is a roll you can make during Kerrigan that basically says, I'm done with my character. I want to start playing now. And I guess the computer made that roll. That's pretty rare. So what AI were you using? You were using 2, which is service skills. You were rolling on the service skill charts, weren't you? I'm going to do it again. Because I want the guy to be 78. Okay, this is more like it. Some guy named Sir Edged. He's 85, disabled, born in 5539. Same planet. We're using the same planet. This time it only rolled 19 characters to make this guy. So he was a scion for 17 terms. What? Nice. So he started out as Nexus 5. So his UPP was CAA8CB. 5 background skills. He's got survival, animals, trade, art, and comms. He encounters a psionic institute. Goes in for the testing. He has a strength of 5. He has a strength of 5, but he ends up with an 8. Okay, this will be interesting. Like I said, he was focusing on something, that's for sure. So at age 17, this all happened at the age of 17. He makes connections with a new contact. At 21, he's an initiate. He gains a mentor. 25, he gains a mentor. 29, he has a chance to use his powers unethically to better his standing. He chooses not to. All right. At 33, he's given advanced training for adept. He learns telepathy plus 1. 37, he has a chance to use his powers unethically to better his standing. He chooses not to. At 41, he becomes a master. An ex-lover tracks him down. At 45, he gains an ally. 49, he achieves a new level of psionic strength. At 53, a working friend betrays him and becomes his rival. At 57, he makes an unexpected connection outside his normal circles, gains a contact. At 61, he achieves a new level of psionic strength, goes up again. At 65, he makes an unexpected connection outside his normal circles, gains a contact. He becomes involved in a new romantic relationship. Aging crisis begins. His strength is brought back to one. At 73, he's given advanced training, but he learns nothing. Then aging crisis, he learns nothing again. Aging crisis, everything's 1-1-1-1. At 81, he's still a master, rank 6. He has a chance to use his powers unethically to better his standing. He chooses not to. He left the Scion career after 17 terms. And he musters out with 4,000 credit, 4,000 credit, 2 ship shares, 4,000 credit, TAS, a contact, a TAS, 2 ship shares, combat implant. Wow. 10 ship shares. What? How many ship shares? He has 16 ship shares. What? A contact. TAS. How many TAS memberships do you have, dude? Another TAS. I'm counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, he's got 6. Another combat implant. 2 more ship shares. Another combat implant. Wow. That was interesting. And then this uncle guy. I should be putting this in a mind map. Okay, the uncle guy has a brother who is not psionic, but he is in the Navy. Source 12. Maybe education of 8 at least. And what would he be? No, he'd be a Nexus 5. Why not? And he has the same last name as his brother. So copy, paste. Anything else? So this guy was born in 5539. His brother's going to be born in 5542. I guess what, he's a year older than his brother? Is that, I can't remember what his age, anyway. Yeah, he looks like a year older than his brother. If I remember. So look what all, let's see. He's a baronet. So he got a lot of stuff. At 18, he becomes a wastrel, a mishap. An assassin attempts to end his life. He has a few minor cuts and bruises from the incident. He becomes a scout, specializes in survey. His ship is one of the first on the scene to rescue the survivors of a disaster. The success gained him a contact, an advancement for promotion. He's now a rank 1 scout. Involved with a crime, he loses his benefit role for this term. At age 30, his ship is one of the first on the scene to rescue the survivors of a disaster. He gains another contact. At 34, he's dealing with an alien race. He has the opportunity to gather extra intelligence about them. He succeeds and gains an ally in the Imperium, along with a +2 DM, blah, blah, blah. At age 38... someone close to him gives birth. Okay. Maybe it's somebody he rescued dealing with an alien race. No, he was the first ship on the scene to rescue some survivors. That's probably what happened. Let's see. A working friend betrays him and becomes his rival. At 46, he's dealing with another alien race. He succeeds in gaining extra intelligence about them and gains an ally in the Imperium. So he's got two allies now. At 50, he's a senior scout. A mishap happens, his ship is damaged, and he has to hitchhike his way back across the stars to the nearest starbase. And then he gets a bunch of money. He gets drafted into the Navy. What happened there? He got drafted into the Navy. What? At the age of 54. Rank 0. Crewman. Wow. His lover may be cheating on him. That's not good. He attempts a commission role and succeeds. He's now an ensign. A lucky break finds him good fortune he's dreamed of. He gains 2 benefit points. At 62, he's a sub-lieutenant. Commanding officer takes an interest in his career. He gets promoted. The aging crisis begins. He's promoted to lieutenant. At the age of 66, he has an opportunity to abuse his position for profit. He chooses not to and gains advancement. He gets promoted again. He pays money to get his dex and endurance put back in order. At 70, he's a commander. His vessel participates in a diplomatic mission. He gains 1 steward. He gains steward 1, I mean. Let's see. He pays money to stay alive. At 74, he's given advanced training, but he gains nothing. Let's see here. He has to spend a lot more money to stay alive still. At 78, he's now an admiral. His vessel participates in a notable military engagement. He gains turrets 1. Almost said Tourette's one. And he leaves the Navy career after 7 terms. See, that's how it's supposed to be done. You don't just make that role that just says, oh, I want to start playing the game now. I'm done making this. I'm done with this Cara Gen stuff. He's ending gracefully. Dun da da da. I mean, it helps to complete a term. If you don't complete a term, I guess you just end. You don't get mustered out. You don't get any mustering out benefits. So at 78, he's leaving. He's doing his final swan song in the Navy as an admiral. His strength, dex, and endurance are at 1. He's getting all kinds of money. He's getting ship shares. He's got a ship's boat. It used AI number 4. Which one's that? Is there 1, 2, 3? He was rolling on the officer skills. That's why he became an admiral, I'm guessing. So, what does he got here? He's got diplomat, blade, capital ships. Capital. He's got leadership, mechanic, naval tactics, sensors, small craft, spacecraft, steward 1. He's the admiral and he was a steward. When I was a youngin', I was a steward. Now I'm an admiral. He's got streetwise, turrets. So he's Nexus 5, but he's 111. Is that really 111, or is it his Nexus 5 programming? So he has a Soci of 12. So where does it say Admiral? Does it say Admiral in here somewhere? Yeah, Admiral right here. Do I want... I'm thinking now. If you become Admiral, do I want the title here to be Admiral for their name, or do I still want it to be Baronet? Like, when I worked for the military, I wasn't in the military, but I was working for the military as a, what do they call those things? What is it? What was it called? Can't remember now. I wasn't a contractor. I wasn't a military contractor. I was actually working for the I was a Department of Defense employee. And what was that called back then? Anyway, I would just tell people, I'm a civilian. I had all these badges and cards to get into things. I'm a civilian. I'm here to fix your computers so you can drive your things. So you can make your aircraft carrier do what it needs to do. And they let me in. They let me on the boat. So... yeah, because these lieutenant... I would be talking to lieutenants. I can't remember what rank a lieutenant was. And then someone told me that my rank is basically the same as a lieutenant's. But not in the military. I'm not in the military. I'm as something else. Can't remember what it is. Not GS. It's not that nonsense. So, in the as a computer guy, free range computer guy, I can go to military bases and just fix whatever needed fixing at the moment while I was there. I was a lieutenant, I guess. But on the civilian side. So I was just computer guy. There's no rank for computer guy. So you're just called Shawner. I remember this was back in late 90s. I would walk into some place and they say, "Who are you?" And I said, "I'm the computer guy." And there's all these women are like, "Oh, I need my send him here. My computer needs fixing more than you guys' computers do." Because I would look at the worst computer problems first, get those fixed, and then the rest of the stuff would be, you know, super easy. Some people say, no, you do the easy stuff first. And then you... well, the problem is the person whose computer's wrecked the most, if they're dealing with, like, paying contractors money for services, you probably want their computer fix first. Or if customers are trying to pay the military to do something for them, they probably want those computers fixed first. If money is being exchanged, those are more important. You know, like in the bowling alley, the movie theater, all the point of sale stuff, those are kind of important to work. You want customers to put money in the things and have them, you know, pay for their stuff at the commissaries and things. But if someone just has a computer they're diddling around with, and they, you know, it's like, this program trains people on how to improve their golf swing at the golf course. I mean, I'll fix it, but there's probably, you know, bartenders probably need their cash registers fixed, so that gets fixed first. Let's see here. I'm going to do one more. What the heck? Nope. I'm just curious how long it takes for these things to run. So the last one only took 16 characters before it made the right one. And now we're already in 160 characters. 200 characters. it depends on the AI. Sometimes the AI wants to win the game by making a min-maxed character. Okay, this time it did 365 characters before it finished. And it was using an AI of 2, which is service skills. Maybe service skills takes longer to make the right character? I don't know. Because each character was using a different AI, so I'll never know. I will never know. I need to, when I save the, it saves the character, let's see, maybe I can share this. It saves the data as raw data. Okay, this looks, could they make this look any uglier in Notepad Plus? Okay, so up at the top here, it's got location, homeworld, starport, size, atmosphere, hydrographics, population, government, law level, tech level, trade codes, trade trap, you know. Those are the headings. Maybe if I go in here and choose which one? Which one? No, don't want that. What if I want? I don't know. Maybe, is it this one then? There we go. So each of these characters is going to have the same homeworld. Same location on the hex map. But over here is where, let's see, here's where the character starts. It's got the traveler name. And they're all human. Male, female, blah, 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 blah. So what was the one I did? The last one I did. Do they all this? They all have the same last name. That's weird. So the last one I did was a Marquise Austin Odie something something. And he was a drifter, and then he was a Navy dude. So he's this bottom dude here. So if I go over here to I need to put in here something like what AI was used when the character was created. So it would just be, it wouldn't be traveler specific, it would just be something my app would look at or look for. But starting here, these are the skills that character has. And why is that field so wide? Did somebody use it up? Somebody almost did. This person's got, how many yachts did this person get? That's a bit much. So how old were they? They have all that stuff, and they don't have hardly any skills. This person has way more skills, and they only got 3 ship shares. How? must be a noble. Nobles get all this stuff. Yeah, a noble. The person above him was a drifter. They didn't get squat. Drifters don't get anything when they muster out. It helps if you're nobility in there. It helps if you've been in the nobility for 15 years. That's probably a key right there. That's what gets you, if I'm looking at the right line, yeah, that's what gets you 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 yachts. At some point, you don't even park those in your house garage. You park those at a starport, at a high port somewhere. What, what was the tech level of this planet again? Tech level 10, I guess. With a C starport? Oh, that's right. This is the one that has almost no water. You need a respirator to even go outside. Thin atmosphere, tainted. Only hundreds of people live on this planet. Well, he's Nexus 5, so he can survive. He's doing okay. He's 84. He's still alive. He's got zero debt. Apparently, he had money to spend on his aging crisis. I need to fix the Nexus 5 routine so that... I mean, this is a homebrew thing. If you choose Nexus 5 or Nexus 6, you don't go through an aging process. Or if you do, it's merely cosmetic to make people think that you're normal and that you're aging like everyone else is, but you don't really suffer a penalty for it. Anyway, I gotta go play some Skyrim or something. And then watch this stream and see if it even recorded. An hour and a half almost. Okay.